I had the idea that it would be an interesting approach to combine many thoughts and analysis of CCTV images and images from medicine, combine them with cinematic images. And I think cinema and film has a very strong tradition in that, especially documentary, of course, to be a kind of control, social control way of perceiving, which we have been educated to in the last, I don't know, 110 years. I try to shoot images which have a certain ambiguity, which don't focus on specific gestures or movements, but more on a more or less ambiguous way of perceiving. Most of the film is shot in wide shots, which is, you cannot really identify faces or people. Well, there are some exceptions, but most of it has a, you get an image of a life in public space, more or less, and different small events happening. And I think this is a tradition which is connected to film. And surprisingly, many of these ways of perceiving images are used in surveillance context as well, but with the difference that you get that a possible observer is just interested in the image as a means of information and not in as an aesthetical means as film is used. Well, I think images and especially film images have two sides, which is the one side would be the actual side of the image, that is what you actually can see, what somehow creates sense and meaning. And there is a darker side of the images as well, which have been called virtual by Gilles Deleuze and other writers, a virtual side of the images which point to the past and the future and some possibilities of a in that sense that they contain something, but we cannot see it because our interest in the image already narrows down our sense of viewing at them. So and the conclusion would be that there is always a kind of surplus value in the image. There's always something more which you can than just which you can see. There's in the film there's an example of an Alzheimer patient. The image tells us he has Alzheimer, but he hasn't any of the symptoms of it. So this sleeper metaphor is being transferred to medicine as well. And there's this funny, radiologists use this funny term of a vomit, yeah, which is a victim of modern imaging technology, because these images tell us how we should behave in order to not to get sick or decide if we want to give birth to a somehow disabled or handicapped child or not. And all this ethics and morality is being transferred in a democratic way. Everybody has to decide what the future would hold. And that was a very striking and of course a very, it was a field which needs analysis, I think.